look at the literally billions of dollars that governments are spending all over the world to build underground shelters and storage capacities, you wonder if they know something we don't.
Well, why haven't I gotten anything in my mailbox about where the nearest underground shelter is to me? I mean, is this something that you think, based on the fear that perhaps we should have, that people should be, giving notice of?
Well, I think it's worth a raised eyebrow, and I'm sorry you didn't get your notice. But I think that when we look at the press and we look at where governments are spending their money, for instance, recently Russia announced that they're building 5,000 more underground shelters. Why? Because they don't have enough shelters for all their people. Against what? And of course, we've been building a lot of them here in this country, and that's also the subject of a lot of conspiracy theories. But if those kinds of shelters are being built, and we have, I just about forgot about this one, NASA's little video warning that went out to all the family of NASA employees to get their food storage together, get their water storage together, have an escape plan so that they can go from where they are to where their family is should the communication systems be knocked out. It's very real.
And it's a very real possibility.
Of course it is. We have taken geological samples up near the Arctic Circle that show a very broad range of alignments of the poles of the Earth. Now, these alignments occur when lava comes up through the crust and then it freezes. It assumes the magnetic alignment of the Earth at that time. But when we go up near the Arctic Circle, we see these tectonic spectrums of north and south pole alignments in mountains and in rock that hasn't moved for hundreds of thousands of years. And guess what? Sometimes it shows the north as south and the south as north. And this is, according to the Coriolis effect, something that could occur rather quickly, like in a matter of days. The north and south poles could switch. There's too much evidence that the poles do shift. North and south poles do shift. And if the core is detached from the crust, as we believe, and the core is thus counter-rotating against the crust, creating our powerful magnetic field, which we call a magnetosphere, if all those things are true and line up, then we are setting ourselves up where the planet is set up to do a Coriolis flip, that the north and south poles could flip. And I mean in somewhere between 72 hours and 5 days, this flip could be complete. Now, it doesn't take an atmospheric physicist to understand what's going to happen, but I'll explain it briefly. The north hemisphere and the southern hemisphere have different weather patterns. For instance, if you drain water down the tub in Australia, it goes clockwise instead of counterclockwise and opposite up here. Well, the jet stream does exactly the same thing. Clouds move counterclockwise and clockwise in different areas, and so do the oceanic currents. If all of those things move and move suddenly, you're going to have conditions set up for what's called a global superstorm. Now, these are snowstorms, but they're not ordinary snowstorms. They are super cold, and they cover large geographic areas.
And in terms of the intensity, how intense is it?
Well, according to what we've uncovered in the book, and this goes back 26,000 years as far as we can gather data, we could be facing winds of 300 miles an hour. And those winds could last for a month or more.
That would knock down practically everything.
The facts cannot be denied that every 26,000 years our solar system arrives in this neighborhood. And it seems there is a historical record that some very cataclysmic things happen about this time. Now, we have been off by professionals saying, oh, there's nothing to worry about, everything's going to be fine in 2013 just like it is right now. But those of us that have been watching the cosmological science, geological science, oceanographic science have been showing that there is the trend that the ancients said would happen.
So when you're talking about some of these signs, Brooks, you're talking about some of the natural disasters we've seen, the major earthquakes, hurricanes, flooding. I mean, is this what you're talking about?
If you're in Miami, Florida, and we have a 20-degree cold shift, you're not going to end up with a really, really bad weather. But if you're in Maine, and you got a 20-degree cold shift, you could end up with the weather of Siberia, real easy. And when this 10th planet comes through our solar system every 3,600 years, it just causes severe problems on our planet.